secretary.
If this would be.
For what was supposed to be 3 years, and I got prickly heat so badly, I did about 8 months.
And my dad's over there.
I didn't joke about acroterias, it's as bad as a flamingo. Because when you get to acroterias, all flamingo.
Wasn't there a
happy place
quite happy
as well? Yes, that was where the sport facility was.
That's right, a nice little valley.
Yes.
Go around the corner and it's all pretty and...
Hey guys.
You there?
Hello, how are you?
Not too bad, it's wet, so isn't it?
It's a wee bit wet.
I was wondering if the parade is being tonight. So it's not a free brand of soap, what did you do last year?
I saw a few adverts go out on Facebook. I didn't manage to get that. Did it, it was sort of a big fair or?
No, not really. No, it was the same size as normal, but he didn't have like the big adult flags there. He blind the fun house that was in the other ghost train.
Yeah, there was one big ride I think coming, but then they couldn't come at the last minute.
David's Dodgins?
Yeah, it's Dodgins.
That's his, yeah.
No, he sold that, and he sold that to his brother.
Oh, he sold it to his brother, is he?
Yeah, because his son.
So the Dodgins were there, though?
Yeah, the Dodgins were there, yeah. That was the only big way that was there.
He's a nice guy, actually.
Yeah,
he was
still...
Yeah, absolutely. Sort of you. If you need any help, he'll help you out.
Otherwise, he invested £5 to buy some books and say, I'm going to put some on you.
Well, Ben, that's why I don't give you anything.
I'm glad, Ben, because I think I'm just going to
use it. We are now.
Yes.
That was added on by somebody else. My concern was the glare from the traffic lights.
Right, because this Neil person who is, he's like, I think he's to do with this planning enforcement and compliance officer, was copied into the response from South Gloss to the email I sent, but he's come back asking questions.
So those would be conditions relating to the sites of
Yeah, but he's saying what is the actual lighting issue?
So the lighting issue I had was the traffic lighting issue.
Sorry. We'll suspend the start meeting.
Sorry.
Everybody feel?
One I raised was about the traffic lights causing large amounts of glare that made it difficult to see pedestrians waiting to use the crossing in darkness. Well, it is impossible.
Right, so traffic lights causing large amounts
of
glare. So
no.
This is at night.
Yeah, and then warnings and things like that.
Yeah.
Yeah, especially when they're all green. That is,
so that's the real issue then?
Yeah, I mean, so when you look at the crossing, you've got, for that small crossing, they've got two traffic lights this side of the road, two that side of the road, so you've got four lights.
Yeah.
It's on
the crossing. It's all a bit.
Yeah, watch out, there is wet paint everywhere, so just be careful.
Yeah, is that why we're in the.
It's good paint again.
Yeah, grey is the new colour, isn't it?
Grey is the new black or something.
Yeah, it's been like that.
Yeah.
So you can't watch it. It's actually lost a pink grey.
Okay.
Okay. Okay. Start. Welcome introductions. Intros, emergency evacuation procedure in the event of a fire alarm, fire drill, or other emergency, signal by a continuous sounding of a bell, please exit from the room via the exit door as indicated, and assemble at the meeting point in the car parking area. I don't know if you've got any umbrellas, but. Okay, I'll read this. Filming, recording, as we see. In line with the openness of local government bodies, regulation 2014, this meeting may will be filmed, recorded by 10 council members of the public. Submissions from the public, 15 minutes. The meeting may be formally adjourned for this item, which we'll do. Residents of Bradley Stoke wishing to make a statement or ask a question are required to give their name and address before making a statement or asking their question. Maximum 5 minutes per person is allowed within the overall limit of 15 minutes. There will be no opportunity later in the meeting for the public to speak. Have you got any items from the public?
No, I'm just here as a slight imposter living in Stoke Gifford Parish. Just wanted to see how you ran things, Ray.
Oh, okay. Right, that's fine.
I don't know if this is probably the right time perhaps to put in two sentences about the meeting I went to on the Hobble helicopter centre.
Well, yeah.
I can't think where else to do it.
Yeah.
The council asked me to be its representative there. There was a meeting about a fortnight ago. The whole thrust of the meeting was basically from the village of Hotham. Sorry, you're trying to use the area, can't you? Complaining about the noise the helicopters were making. The operator said they were going to do some tests on the sound, and they were also going to change, as an experiment, the route of the helicopters coming into the landing site. The challenge was, or the interesting thing was, that if they came straight in, they made one lot of noise over a longer distance. But if they came in on a shorter distance and then turned in, because of the turn, it was noisier on the helicopter blades. So it might actually cause greater annoyance to some residents. But they're going to do the tests and then report back. And I say, I don't think it was a flight path that was going to affect us very much.
Yeah, I think under the planning it would be regularly monitored anyway, and there was a lot of people complaining from the area well before and took it to task, you know, really went outside of the planning jurisdiction and had to be looked at externally by an inspector, and he came back and he said fine, so, but it's all there.
I got the impression that some of these permissions were time limited.
Well, they're there.
Yes, I know.
Yeah. I'm not sure.
It might be up for review after.
I think so.
Yeah, well, perhaps I got it wrong.
Interesting. I'll have I'll ask. Right, to receive any apologies for absence?
Councillor Keith Cronny and Councillor Elaine Hardwick.
Okay. Any declaration by members under Local Government Act 1972? No announcements by the Chair? no real announcements. I must admit, not necessarily a planning matter, but we have had some quite nasty incidents in North Crowley Stoke recently with police cordoned off cul-de-sac. And that's actually happened now twice within not very many weeks. I understand there was quite a few people which were attacked in one of the cul-de-sacs. So if there's any support. So it's a great shame that these things happen. Okay. I'll move on to confirm the minutes of the meeting on the 24th of July 2019 is the correct record.
Yeah.
Page one. And page two. Page three. Page four. Page 5. Page 6. Page 7. And page 8.
Yeah.
Tom?
Purple sack.
Oh, yeah, it's okay. Okay. Yeah, it's fine. I must admit, I would like to compliment Sharon for the minutes. She's doing a really cracking job on it. And I read through them to approve them before you guys saw them. But they've got, you know, draft boys. Okay. So that's confirmed.
Can we have a vote, please?
You have a vote, please. Consider any matters arising for a minute to the meeting, not covered elsewhere on the agenda. And what is? And 6.1, Bradley Stoke environmental statement relating to the town.
If you remember, councillors were going to come send me through some bullet points that we could look at incorporating into an environmental statement, but nobody actually sent me anything. Can we carry this forward and then perhaps the councillors could put their minds to it for that chart over the next month? Just some.
Yeah, look for thought, yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Cool, Mayor.
actually, it was proposed by Ben to be go
because of the things, which is really good there for combat, you know.
Okay.
Never really
yeah.
contribute, you know.
That would be good.
Want to frame all of
and I know Ben's quite interested because he's very young, he's going out with us all.
Yeah.
That has been said. Right, okay. Right. You could put that anywhere. Seven, to note the outcome of the previous planning applications and other documents pertaining to planning and environmental issues.
That's tabled. There were 5 decisions, 4 of which agreed with Town Council. The one that we said yes to and the South Ross said no to was the prior notification for householder. They said it needed a proper planning application.
Okay.
We've actually got that tonight. So.
Yeah, is this fine? Good.
Okay, 8, to prepare responses for the proper authority to run planning application relating to Bradley Stoke.
You have that
table
because there's
1 extra one there. Oh, the feedback. Feedback good also. That's the one you're talking about.
What about
5? I don't know what's going on in that tent.
It's that. Press the Windows key and P. The Windows key.
That one.
And
what?
And P at the same time. And get it to say duplicated.
And does it keep doing that? Did that last one? I think you told me the same thing. Right, so the first one is P1909456. ABV, which is display of 6 internally illuminated fascia signs. If you remember, we had 1 planning application last month for masses of signs on the car parking and the surrounding area. And this, I think, is a, which literally came in the day after our meeting, is now for signs to be attached to the McDonald's building. We managed to get the planning officer to agree an extension, even though actually it's well past its comment date, but he did agree that we could have an extension to our.
I know we got the same place with this one as we were with the previous one. How can we have an application for a building that doesn't have permission?
Well, yeah, I mean, I would suggest if councillors are minded that you use the same objection that you used last month, which you had obviously in your agenda pack.
Sure.
Which was an objection on grounds of no planning permission being granted for this building.
Yeah.
The following explanatory note to be added to the response, the Town Council objected to the planning application for the McDonald's building, which was subsequently refused planning permission. Therefore, there is no building and roadworks permitted for the signs to be affixed to or installed beside, and as such, this application does not make sense.
Yeah.
So I think this one, would be, you could take out the reference if you wanted to,
yes,
the roadworks and a bit to be installed beside, because this is just,
Chair, from the last meeting, as you could see, we objected that in strong words. I don't know what makes sense, certainly they're coming back with the same thing.
Well, no, this is a different application.
But the same thing, isn't it?
Yeah, but I think both of them, because if you look at the application numbers, they're both quite similar. So the one last month was 09453 and this one is 09456. So I think they were probably submitted at the same time. It's just South Boss took longer to process this one.
Yeah, with reference to P19/09453/ADV, I would like to, with reference to that, I object. Proposed objection on grounds of no planning permission being granted to them for this building, and we actually already objected to it.
I mean, it's really 6 and 2/3, isn't it? We're exactly the same situation. We're being asked to prove something on a building that doesn't have the planning permission.
You seconded it that
time. That's right. Yeah.
It's almost like subverting your original objection because you've. Through the signage. question.
We put in front of us signage for our fresco roof letters for old sign 5. But the building, which is shown there, isn't a two-storey building.
It's just for representation.
That's just showing you what the sign's going to be like. This is that's the
okay,
sign elevation.
We go back to that one. We cannot see a sign like that.
Is that a two-storey building, or is it just one of the very high windows?
There it is on the side of the building, McDonald's.
Or
yeah.
A fake letter.
Yeah.
That's
over
the,
there.
That's the white restaurant.
Right. It's interesting. Because they colored those in, but didn't colour that.
Yeah.
And I must admit.
And the golden arches, but not the white writing.
I must admit, that's probably the smallest McDonald's signs I've ever seen on a building. So that's
where the signs are going. So that's the roof.
Yeah, I suppose in white it would be difficult to actually show it on there.
I don't know
if you want to add, you can't really see it. I know you're saying, Ben, that it just seemed very... I missed it the first time completely. Almost be like that white letter that you get on glass.
It's
where do we need
to get any lights on projections on?
Yeah. And they are due to be illuminated as well.
Yeah.
Internally illuminated fascia signs, so it will be quite bright.
Yeah. Okay.
Next on proposed objection.
Oh, on second that, yes.
So it would be the same objection with explanatory note before, but just take out the reference to the road works and the bit about it being installed beside.
Mm-hmm. I wonder if it's worth making reference also to the fact that we did object to the previous one, just in case they think that we're looking at this in new.
I think it's subject to appeal anyway, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
The
19th. No, because it's written representations now, so I don't know. The closing date for submissions was the 21st of August. So I don't know how long it will take the planning inspectorate to then read through everything. I guess we'll just have to sit and wait for the decision. I don't know. I might be
on the old.
Can you vote on that, please?
Okay, thank you for getting the town's response back. Quite quickly, Sharon, to that. I think all the councillors saw the representation you made to the inspector.
I did try to alert the school as well, the secondary school, but I don't know where, because obviously they're on school holiday, and I sent it to many email addresses as I could find.
I sent my objection in as well, and Sarah sent quite
Roger sent it very nicely
detailed.
Yeah, Roger sent it also. Yeah,
Roger spent an awful lot of time on it from what I remember.
Okay. Right.
Sure.
Next one. P190962 PDR erection single story rear extension for additional living accommodation at 4 Fennel Drive. This house on the end here.
Mm-hmm. Is this the plan?
This is the elevation.
don't think how we see how we object to that. It's in a fairly open area anyway.
So they're changing the conservatory room.
For that?
Yeah, chair.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's good.
Okay. Okay, we'll go on that.
One, two, three. Thank you very much.
Do you know why this one? Is it because of the lack of planning application? It's so rejected? This 16th person.
No, I think, I guess because I'm assuming that they must have thought that it was too big a extension to go through as the prior notification of householder dwelling. Does that seem reasonable to those councillors in the row?
Seems to be nothing. I think it shows just over 4 metres, isn't it?
Yeah. So, 16, 19, 0, 9, 9, 2, 1, PDR, 16 Crystal Way, erection single story rear extension to form additional living accommodation. It is this house on the end here, if you remember. So, you saw it.
It's looking better. This is an old wall.
Using blue bricks.
Yeah.
And go back to the aerial view, please. Shall
we? Okay.
The aerial.
The aerial view, it does look rather cramped.
There.
I don't feel any objection to that. Because, but it's fully covering the whole area, is it? Yeah. So the boundary to the boundary.
I think it balances the house. At the end of the day, you've got a three-story house. It's quite small, the actual footprint of that.
Any objection? Any other objections from the council?
There's nothing from anybody. I don't think it's been in the system for quite a long time. There's absolutely nothing in there as well.
Can we please just have a look at that application form, just to know what was the, if there is mention of anything, this application form? Just to be clear, when we are giving it a...
Okay.
ones.
Is there anything that's written why they are going to resubmit the application?
Well, because it got refused. They were told by South Gloss they had to put in a planning application as opposed to just prior notification, which would have meant that they didn't need a planning application. Because that got refused.
That's
it's interesting though, isn't it? Because you know it's actually increasing by 4 metres. And you think that would be fine because under the new rules, that should be okay. And the actual height.
Okay.
But they do.
I don't have any objection to it, but that's.
Okay, we've got a proposal. Okay, so.
Tom proposed.
What's the seconder? Never seconded.
Thank you.
You will vote on that, please.
All in favour? 3, 4, 5 in favour. Against?
One abstention.
Through the year, but it's all PT19s.
Yeah, but if you look now, they've gone into the. They suddenly started PT9. Putting a zero in front of them, and now
yeah.
We're actually, by the time we get to the fifth one on here, it's actually, that's 11,365. Because they've combined, haven't they, Thornway and Kingswood, so they've all got one number now.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's quite a lot of planning applications.
Well, I've noticed on a lot of them. Well, they've got rid of the PT as well. It's just gone down.
Yeah, they're all just P now.
Yeah.
Rather than PT and PK. Next one is P190956F, units 17 and 18 equals Wood Business Park, Woodlands Lane, Gravel Stoke. Removal of vent panel and pedestrian access door on southern elevation and installation of two enlarged vehicular access doors and four windows, removal of two wall vents and replacement with it matching brickwork on northern elevation, removal of fire exit and two vented roofs on the eastern elevation and installation of two glazed wall sections. What's there at the moment? That's what's there at the moment. What's there at the moment, so you've obviously got the shutter on that side, but not on that side. New door on that side. Doors and shutters on the east elevation. Now, we'll continue windows on the
Is the removal of the fire exit an issue?
What is the comment from the council?
Nobody has any issues with it, environment protection, or construction system.
Any comments from the public? That's fine. Okay, so that proposal?
Yep.
One proposal?
Proposal.
And seconder? Thanks, everyone.
Seconded,
Mike. Nothing further. Seconded?
No, he's proposed.
Okay. Fab proposed it.
Oh, seconded, yes. Okay, sorry. I thought she was seconding what Tom said, I'm sorry.
Okay, can you have a vote on that, please?
Thank you very much.
Part would be referred to orange, wouldn't you?
So you have the same amount of the 11,000 here. P19 11365 PDR, erection of single story rear extension to form additional living accommodation and erection of front canopy at 58 Marjoram Place, Bradley Stoke. So it is this house here, isn't it?
Mm-hmm.
Quite a big house, isn't it?
It's a lovely road, that road.
It's that house here, obviously, that's as far as we can get on the Google Street map. Tried something different actually, highlighted them all and then downloaded them from the South Gloss website, so they haven't got my explanatory things on them, they've got the South Gloss ones in case you
clocked
the fact that they were different.
What is the application form with that last name?
It's just the application form. That's what I'm saying, it's exactly the same documentation, but I've just highlighted them and then downloaded them to a zip file for a trial.
They always redact the personal name for the signature and everything.
Isn't it?
No objection.
I propose something. Yeah. lovely houses.
Is that a proposal?
Yeah.
Yes, that was a proposal.
Michael. Reflection. You're in. Reflection on your face.
Can we second it?
Yeah. Okay, can you have a put that piece and keep it for her?
I think so. Five in favour. One against.
One reflection, is that? Right. He's not in place.
We've turned that how you prefer it.
Okay.
That's it for eight. Brian, over to you.
Okay, you didn't actually mention anything to do with the 50 space car park, did you, or not?
The what, sorry?
Change of use of land, 50 space car park, was that last one? That one there.
No, that was the final decision from last time.
Oh, yeah.
Item seven, this is this one.
Yeah, okay.
And that's what about this?
What's primary?
No, we are.
Here we go.
Just because I this is so small, I.
Not what you want. Doesn't happen very often.
Number nine.
Deal with matters referred to where within the scope of the planning environment which is not covered elsewhere. STC puts action on the expansion. It's back on the stakeholder needs on the update. And you went to it, didn't you?
Right, you have the. Well, there hasn't been a meeting recently, so you have the update in your agenda pack. And then via email last week came the diagram, which is tabled, so it's this one with all the road signs on it, which says, following feedback from the June closure of Gypsy Patch Lane, we have been, this is from South Wales Council, we've been considering options for the increased signage during the approximate 8 month closure next year. Please see attached an initial signage strategy which could be implemented for the closure next year to help further support the community. This is over and above standard signage for highway closures. The signs being considered explain that businesses in the area are open as usual and make it clear that access to the different businesses is possible. The attached document also details where we are considering putting the signs on local roads. This strategy would be in addition to the standard businesses open as usual signage we put out during the road closure. We would appreciate it if you could take the time to look at the proposals attached, and if you have any comments, email them by Monday the 9th of September. We will then designate time at the next stakeholder liaison group meeting to discuss the comments we receive. Once we've gathered all your feedback, we will come back to you with a finalised strategy later in the year. Thank you for your continued engagement with the project. So, I have. But it's
fair.
Well, I was thinking I might be able to zoom in and then I can actually read the signs properly, but I don't know.
I mean, I think you've got, it's a high detailed PDF, isn't it?
I think it's the pale grayness of it that doesn't help matters.
Yeah, that's it's good. At least they actually have done something.
That's 25% zoom, you should better get out of the box.
Then you're not going to be able to see much on the page at any one time, right? That's the thing.
They appear to have listened though.
Yes, they have definitely listened.
Can we see what they're writing on that Pegasus Park?
I must admit, when this was put through on planning, it was done with the condition that signage would be in place. For the you know, the businesses in all the place, etc. What they did from that, they sort of, well, it seemed to be that they ignored it, and then there was councils contacting them, etc. And I think the recent closure, which is a few weeks,
you know, show how terrible those businesses basically, because people are not going to go down these roads if they feel it's all blocked off.
And actually, these two signs are really interesting, because when all the different councillors and the businesses asked for signs with specific businesses detailed, South Gloss said, we can't do that either.
It needs to be there.
But now they've obviously gone away and looked into it further, because then people were coming up with examples of places where councils in other areas of the country had actually put individual signs, you know, business names.
I think two comments, if I may, Chairman. I think, first of all, those two large ones on the right-hand side, there's no mention of Rolls Royce, and of course there is an access to Rolls Royce from the City Batch Lane.
On the A38.
Access to
there. No, that's not.
Car park. It is, but it's still access to it, isn't it?
No, those people will be notified because they actually work there. But the but effectively access to Rolls Royce is from the A38.
The main entrance is the front.
I used to see a number of cars that go in and out of Gypsy Patch Lane, rush hours. And the other point, of course, is there's so much development going on behind the village hotel, but this will need to be kept under review, because there are going to be more companies going onto that large site there as time goes on.
Horizon 38, that's the site there.
Yeah, that's that one, isn't it? That's the main site, Horizon
38. But obviously, by the time I thought the work would finish.
Okay.
You're being optimistic, Tom.
Yeah, very optimistic.
So what is the actual slide of that? That big one.
Bear with me a second, I will zoom in.
Yeah.
I guess it will be on there.
Oh, that's good.
1,375 millimetres. So it's just over a metre there, isn't it?
3.185. 3.185, so it's 3 metres wide, isn't it? 3 metres wide. That is excellent.
You know what's
going to
happen? People are
going to
be saying
it's too many
signs.
It's too confusing.
No, it's excellent. No,
it's
very good.
Yeah,
you know, it's not Mickey Mouse stuff, is it?
It shows that they have listened
to
the
business.
Yeah,
to be honest, I feel we need to congratulate the council for adhering to response from the residents and the comments. I think that we can do.
Yeah,
especially
so.
If the original message that was basically sent out was that, well, we can't do any of this.
That's a proposal from Tom. I've got a second that. I think it's a really good proposal, quite frankly.
You see, we've got a railway bridge this time, because it was just generic last time, Gypsy Patch Lane closed.
Yes. People would think it would assume it was the whole area rather than just at the railway bridge. So that was to congratulate.
And thank.
That's a very
listening.
In terms of like revenue,
businesses.
I think they did the right thing at the consultation. It's always going to be a very, very difficult.
But the other one's got history listening, whereas it does seem they did listen this time.
Mm.
Hopefully it worked.
That was proposed by Tom and seconded by Brian.
Yeah. I do think we need to make the point that this needs to be kept under review, because there are already some large buildings going up on that site behind the village hotel.
Yeah.
And I can imagine that Blogs and Company, 6 months down the road, are going to say,
I think,
why aren't we on that?
I think Andy basically coined it, because the thing is, you can't, you know, I mean, if there are any other people going in there, but you actually have got the main companies and Horizon 38, so.
Because these ones here are actually the ones directly affected, because they're the ones closest to Gypsy Patch Lane, aren't they? But Horizon 38 covers a larger area, I think, doesn't it?
The
back,
The Westwick side, Westwick side.
And, it's because one thing is the revenue lows of those companies, that's why these things came up. So that's what, but new companies coming in, they know what the situation is, they will also advertise. But we can actually review that, and hopefully we'll
need to keep an eye on it.
Yeah. But we can actually, we can keep it in a review or something, with operating.
I mean, Strenco Tools have only been open 2 or 3 months now, they have new people come in. There's another very large building going up there. It's on Horizon 38, but not everybody is going to realise that Horizon 38 covers the entire site. And the individual companies going on there won't get a mention.
I can't remember which year it was, it's either 2007 or 2009 or 8, something like that. We had a planning application for the entire site.
Mm-hmm.
And we approved it. And I should always remember speaking at the site visit and then on the planning meeting, you know, try and get some 106 money to actually widen the bridge from these developers. And Keith Cranny was really in favour of that. And so at the main meeting, he actually spoke on it. We must get some 106 money. Make sure we get some 106 money. So we then put the planning permission through, and then nothing happened because country's in recession and it just didn't start. So, you know, all went into a bed. So now, of course, when we'll be in there getting the bridge point, Keith has been one of those absolutely furious about closing the road and everything.
So that was the fire that pulled down the old ones with somebody initially, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. But I mean, interesting enough, the hotel at the time was stymied for a height because of the airfield. It was off to one side, but it was still stymied for sight because of the airfield and planes. And I spoke to one of the planning officers not long ago about this when the building was going up. And I said, I can't understand why they never came back and actually extended the height of the hotel, because hotels are a lot higher than that quite often. And they said, no, we can't understand either, because the planes aren't there anymore, because
yeah,
that was a sort of
yeah.
restriction on it. So it seems they could have made it a lot taller.
Yeah, sure.
So
yeah,
the proposal was to congratulate and thank South Gloss Council on listening to the local businesses and residents re-signage. This needs to be kept under review for any new businesses opening.
I think
the
that's
interim.
A sensible suggestion. Yeah.
Thank you.
So that was proposed by Tom and seconded by Brian.
All
right. Can
you
take a vote on that?
Yeah.
Mm.
Well, that's good, isn't it?
Thank you.
Well, I think our recommendation paid off. Yeah. Okay, 9.2, South Gloss Council Construction Speed Table, Roehampton, Bosley Way, consultation.
If you remember, we had this a while ago with the traffic regulation order, obviously, for the work, and now they're actually going to do the work, so they obviously come back. We did ask them that, but obviously they didn't have the money for that, but they that would cost you more money.
So that is our response, except this is what they could do, is it?
This is all they could do, yeah. We did ask them if they could actually put proper telephone costs down, but obviously this is what they've got the funding for, so.
What difference it makes? Have they said any difference in funding, but this one, the project, and the one here.
I did. I would guess it was a lot more probably put in paper.
And the
electricity.
Yeah.
I think sometimes the officers get a bit cagey about pelican crossings when there's not a lot of traffic all day long. So in other words, when you know if you've got a pelican crossing, some people don't push the button. They think the road's clear and you just go rushing across. And it's a lot of traffic, a lot of pedestrians going, and there's lots and lots of police traffic all the time. They're tend to put men.
And also, road humps do speed, slow traffic, don't they? Whereas, as you say, it's a pelican crossing and there's nobody necessarily at it that doesn't slow the traffic down.
And they're expensive. You know, I think some there has been occasion where I know putting them in would be dangerous. This particular one might not be, because it's got reasonable visibility.
They are putting power in because they're putting beacons in.
It is more expensive, but sometimes it can create a problem. I'm saying we've done this.
It's a consultation, so what should be our response? I think.
Yeah, response would be thank you very much for doing something, because it needed doing. You know, it's been there a long time. I know I got involved with it a long time ago, trying to get some kind of speed bumps and things like that. And certainly recently, the money's come through to say, what's the issue to get on with these things?
Proposed is just reduce traffic speed approaching zebra crossing near the Goldstrands Green Primary School.
We should look for are there any further comments from Rizio from you as a resident?
Proposing no objection to
it? Yeah, no objection.
No second for that.
Thank you.
Okay, we'll vote on that, please. Two of that.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5 in favour. Against? Thank you.
Okay. Next, 10, to deal with matters relating to health and safety.
Nothing.
Next, financial matters, approved bills and debits for payment.
You have it tabled. Very small.
Oh, youth run ladies on the helpline 25? Is it this one?
Pardon?
The youth grantee 125. Is it a one off payment or?
Yes, that was agreed by Leisure Youth and Amenities in August.
Okay.
Signs for the Remembrance Day parade.
Okay, alright.
It's not a subject on which I have a great deal of expertise, but nearly £220 for a single printer cartridge.
No, it's not a printer cartridge.
Oh, it's singular, that's why I queried it.
Loads of cartridges.
No, if it said printer cartridges, I wouldn't have raised it.
Yeah, no.
You should see the cupboard of goodies.
We do use them all, though.
I'll take your word for it.
No massive toner cartridges for huge printers, aren't they?
What is UKTC SW England and Wales refund of credit notes?
That was a hirer who's now cancelled their bookings, I think.
UKTC.
I think Ben might win. It is a massive cartridges. The price of them is sort of like six times the price more domestic.
But the amount of printing the office does.
Yeah, I appreciate that.
That's very low.
And it's very good quality printing, isn't it? Yeah, it's always here and nice.
Ben proposed, I think.
Okay. Second it. Yeah. Second it for approval. Go
going once, going twice. I'll second it.
Take a vote, please. Thank you.
Thank you, Chair. I think it's 1 hour.
You like that?
Meeting Wednesday, 25th September 2019 at 7 p.m. at the FaBS Stoke Jubilee Centre.
Thank you.
Thanks, COVID.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Shut up.